just want to talk about microphone booms. This is something like I've seen on the internet with the YouTubes. Microphone on the end, hollow clip, and something like a painter's pole or similar. The drawback I see with this idea is the weight. You've got a pole with a weight on the end of it, and most will hold up in the air like that. How long are you going to hold your arms up in the air? Even if you put it over your shoulder, you've still got the weight on the air end which you've got to support. Well, camera booms usually have a weight on the end. So I'll show you my version. That's the weight. It's just a box with some metal inside it. I stripped out some wall transformers and I've used the laminations inside. Got a box around it just to tidy it up. And the cable goes up the middle of the pole rather than be on the outside. This pole is an extendable curtain pole. It's made of thin steel, but I'm not worried about the weight, it's, as you'll see. This one is one of the adjustable plates. That bracket there is normally on a finial. I'll just cut it off, it's only plastic, but I've made an adjustment point on there. And as it extends, obviously the cable on the other end feeds to the pole quite nicely. Put some marks on here. That is supposed to be the limit. It's just a guidance thing really. Where is it, that limit there? I've got another mark just here. And when that's there, that is now quite happy balanced. And I can hold that up with one hand. If that hand gets tired, we can change over. Much easier to control. You can even put it on your shoulder and it'll quite happily sit there, and you just gotta keep it in line. I've actually put a strap on there, which I thought about the idea of putting it over the shoulder to keep it as a low level. Then you can raise the other end. Because of its length, you can actually get quite well out of the way of the cameras. So that's a good idea for you guys out there. The other mark on the back is only when it's on a short reach.